Hi, my name is Dave Hughes. I'm an endocrine surgeon here at University of Michigan. I'm the program director for the general surgery residency program as well. Our program has a lot of great support from faculty and obviously our admin chief residents. We have three associate program directors, Dr. Hope Jackson, who's a minimally invasive surgeon, Dr. Ben Ferguson, who's a surgical oncologist, and Dr. Grace Kim, who's also a minimally invasive surgeon. We have program coordinators. Lisa Leininger is our coordinator for our residency program. She's also supported by Sam Peterson, who's a great support for our residents. They really help them navigate the whole process of what it means to be a surgical resident here at Michigan. We have two administrative chief residents every year. These residents are elected by the other residents because of their leadership skills, their ability to organize, their ability to kind of keep everything in perspective when it comes to running the residency program. The mission of our surgical residency program is to train the next leaders in academic surgery in the United States. We like to recruit residents who are interested in academic surgery, but we also maintain that they need to be great clinical surgeons when they're done with residency. First and foremost, they need to be able to operate on all the different diseases that a general surgeon needs to take care of. In addition to that, we want to make sure that their leadership skills, their communication skills, their ability to work with patients and their families is of utmost importance. And we want to make sure that academically our residents are ready to go on and be faculty members all throughout the country at really well-regarded academic institutions. First and foremost, I think it's the people that you get to work with as a resident. People here are nice. They know how to work in teams really well. They know how to respect other people's duties on the teams. They can make sure that everyone has a responsibility that's appropriate for the level of training. And really, they can all come together to provide a really exemplary level of care for the patients. We match our graduating residents into all the different specialties across general surgery in terms of fellowship. Even the most competitive fellowships, we've been very successful at getting multiple residents into those every year, if that's the path that they desire. I think our residents academically really shine compared with other residencies in the country. We have many residents finish with more than 100 publications by the time they're done with their residency. They graduate with more publications than I have. So our surgery residency program is made up of around 50 residents. We have seven categorical general surgery residents that match every year. Those categorical general surgery residents do 5 years of clinical training, and pretty much all of them do 2 years of academic development time, which is our research time, which is situated between the PGY3 and the PGY4 years. We do it a little bit later in clinical training because it helps our residents to have a little bit more idea of what they want to go into in terms of a clinical specialty, which helps map their research to the specialty they eventually go into for fellowship. We also have four undesignated preliminary residents. They're with us for 1 year. Some of those residents are looking to get a categorical general surgery residency position. We've been very successful in matching those prelim residents into categorical positions, either here or other institutions throughout the country. Because of the quality of care that Michigan has been known to provide, we get a lot of referrals from all throughout the state and also from the surrounding states like Ohio and Indiana. Patients get referred here because they have such complex disease, they need the level of care that Michigan can provide. Residents in training benefit from that highly. They will see cases that they wouldn't typically see at some smaller hospitals. And really the patients that come here have lots of comorbidities, they can have really complex disease, which is really important to learn as a resident because it helps you be prepared for absolutely everything when you're out in practice. Your operative experience is excellent every single year. Even our PGY1 residents usually finish with 150 cases. And most of the residents from the PGY2 up to the PGY5 year do about 250 to 300 cases every year. The general surgery residents rotate on all the general surgery services and some additional specialty services, things like cardiothoracic surgery, the intensive care unit. We have a couple off-site rotations. One of those rotations is our community surgery rotation, which is in Chelsea, Michigan, which is about 20 minutes west of town here. And then the residents also spend 1 month at Hurley Hospital, which is in Flint, Michigan, where they get exposure to a little bit different patient population, and it's very trauma heavy, which is, I think, a really valuable experience for the residents. The VA is an excellent service. The residents get a lot of autonomy at the VA. It's also more of a kind of a mixed rotation where they do not only general surgery, but they also do some vascular surgery and some other subspecialties within general surgery. It's a great rotation. The residents really enjoy the VA patients. It's a great clinical experience for them. The University of Michigan hospital system is a very large system. The main hospital site here has the University Hospital, which is about an 800 bed hospital. That's where residents will spend the majority of their time. Also included on the main campus here, we have a cardiovascular care center. We also have the Children's Hospital and the Cancer Center. So all these are within walking distance. They're all connected in a large hospital complex. The VA hospital is just across the river. That hospital provides care for the veterans throughout the state of Michigan and the surrounding area. We have some outpatient surgical centers. Two of those are within Ann Arbor. That's East Ann Arbor. We have a Brighton Center for Surgical Care, which also includes about six operating rooms. Again, a lot of outpatient surgery. It's about 20 minutes north of Ann Arbor. The Chelsea Hospital, which is partially owned by the University of Michigan, is where residents do their community surgery rotation. It's a lot of bread and butter general surgery, but really some advanced laparoscopy and robotics cases happen out there. The majority of other rotations are all within the University of Michigan, and residents will probably spend 95% of their time in the main campus here in Ann Arbor. The typical resident education includes a lot of clinical time. Most of the residents spend about 90% of the time learning clinical skills, learning surgical skills. I think that's kind of first and foremost when it comes to what a residency provides. In addition to that, though, they need to learn to become educators for our medical students and their own junior residents. We have some residences educators courses that are built into our didactic training to make sure that the residents can learn those educational skills for when they go out into practice. In addition to that, they need to learn leadership skills. We have a resident leadership development program, which our residents participate in, not only during their clinical time, but also during their academic development time. On top of that, there's research skills that the residents learn here, primarily during their academic development time. They really learn how to run their own research projects. They know how to develop teams to kind of complete those research projects and then go on to present those at national meetings and obviously get them published in very highly regarded journals. We have a lot of organized educational conferences for the residents. The main one of those is on Thursday morning. That includes a death and complications conference. We have a lot of grand rounds, which vary in topic, everything from clinical topics to leadership topics to health equity. Really great speakers come and teach the residents a lot of great things from other institutions and from our own as well. The Thursday morning conferences, the residents are not required to do any clinical duties. I think it's really important for the residents to be all in when it comes to learning so they can really focus on the topics that are being discussed and obviously to participate fully in the simulation activities that we have for them. After our organized conferences, we have educational didactics for the residents, which usually lasts for about 2 hours. We have a very heavy and well-organized surgical skills curriculum. A lot of that happens at the junior years, but we also have a lot for the senior residents to learn really more advanced skills. This ranges anywhere from basic suturing and laparoscopic skills for our new interns, all the way up to the robotics curriculum that we have, which kind of spans all the different years. It takes a lot of practice to get good at surgery. So really the best place to practice those things is outside the operating room. And we got some great surgical skills curriculums and great surgical simulation models that helps to prepare our residents for actually taking care of patients in the operating room. One of the major missions of the residency program here at Michigan is to make sure we prepare our residents to become academic leaders in surgery throughout the country. And a really integral part of that is the 2 years of academic development time that we have in our program, which happens between the third and fourth clinical years. The academic development time, the residents can really choose whatever they want, and their academic interests are so wide. It spans everything from translational research with mouse models to molecular biology, all the way to the other end of the spectrum where residents focus almost completely on global health initiatives, where they spend a year in Africa during their academic development time. but also they focus on things like health equity, health access, quality improvements. The spectrum of academic projects that they do is really mind-blowing. Mentorship is one of the key aspects of any residence professional development. Mentorship helps you kind of explore different specialties. You'll have a very close contact with obviously all our faculty, but residents tend to generate very close relationships with faculty. They end up being in their own clinical specialty and can really help support them through their fellowship application process and really become friends and mentors throughout their entire career. In addition to the clinical mentorship, there needs to be some academic mentorship that the residents have, not only to help with their academic research projects, but also help secure funding for them. We don't necessarily have an assigned mentor every single year for the residents because we think it's more important that it's a kind of an organic process where the residents can kind of explore different mentors and eventually settle on some main mentors in the senior years. Yeah, I think we have excellent support for our residents, both from an educational side of things, but also from a personal side of things as well. We have amazing residency coordinators. Residency coordinators help to keep our residents kind of up to date on all the different requirements of residency. They also help support our residents to get access to resources, both for educational purposes and for any kind of personal things they have going on outside of the hospital as well. The Office of Surgical Education is a great resource for the residents. It's an office that can not only help support them through all the different regulatory requirements that they have, help to keep their medical license up to date, make sure they're doing all the different requirements for both the ACGME residency program and their board requirements. They also supply them highly with candy and snacks. The residents like to go down there and just touch base with our surgical education office and really generate great friendships with the program coordinators. I think culture is something we do pretty well here at Michigan, and it's because we're kind of all in on supporting each other and understanding that surgical residency is a profession that we do, but it's also not completely defining who we are as people. We all have different personal interests outside of the hospital. It's important to generate those relationships with other residents. We want to make sure that we can provide those social interactions from a programmatic side of things. They help to kind of germinate those friendships as our residents come here as interns. It's difficult to move to a place where you don't know anybody, but the culture here is really welcoming, all the way from the chair of surgery all the way down to your fellow interns that you're going to be joining on July 1st. That supportive environment is really important to get you through a very kind of difficult time in your career, but one that's really important help you be successful in the future. I think the residents develop really friendships with the faculty while they're here. The thing I enjoy the most is when I run into our residents who have graduated 5-10 years ago at national meetings or when we visit other institutions. And I love to hear how much they cherish the time they spent here at Michigan, how formative it was for them in their own professional development, and really to kind of catch up with friends that we've made all throughout the year. That faculty and resident relationship, I think, is really important because it creates a psychologically safe space to learn. I think you need to be kind of comfortable in the operating room, comfortable in the clinical space to help you really concentrate on your own professional development and keep your mind open for learning opportunities.